Welcome to New Jersey Ballet's production of Nutcracker. When the curtain went up on our first Nutcracker, we never dreamed the production would have such an enormous effect on so many people. We got off to a splendid start thanks to spectacular dancing by New York City Ballet star Edward Villella. A splendid orchestra led by Alfredo Silipini. He's flying in from Mexico, so I don't know if he's arrived. The imaginative choreography of George Tomal. And a talented little girl named Carolyn Brown, who grew up to dance with American Ballet Theater and on Broadway. Carolyn? The support of the New Jersey State Council on the Arts, represented this evening by longtime friend of the ballet, Sharon Harrington. That's been a major factor in keeping the arts in New Jersey alive. And tonight we also salute more than 4,500 dancers and children who have performed in the Nutcracker, and an estimated 750,000 people who have seen the production. From the bottom of our hearts, we thank you all. And also on stage is longtime friend and artistic advisor Eleanor D'Antuono, former ballerina of American Ballet Theater, and our assistant artistic director, Paul McCrae, who many of you saw as the Arabian in Nutcracker over the years. And if Miss Harrington, Miss Sharon, would you like to say a few words, or?
Simply, thank you so much. Congratulations on 35 wonderful years, and I bring regards not only from all of the members of the New Jersey State Council on the Arts, who are so proud to support New Jersey Ballet and the Nutcracker, but also a proclamation from Governor Cody, which reads, "The arts affect every aspect of life in America today." And a cherished holiday tradition, New Jersey Ballet's Nutcracker has toured all over New Jersey, and I congratulate them and wish them best of luck going.
Thank you, Sharon. And for Mr. Villella, we have a few words.
It's hard to believe. I mean, anything that survives 35 years, but anything in culture, in art, in dance that survives 35 years is truly an incredible, incredible accolade. To that person over there, that's you, that's you. I'm thrilled and delighted to be here and help enjoy this incredible celebration and moment in the history of New Jersey's cultural moments. Thank you very much.
An absolutely incredible human being who changed the face of ballet in the United States with all his touring and work with regional companies, internationally danced in many, many theaters across the world, Kennedy Center honoree, all sorts of things. Wonderful, wonderful person. And Eleanor?
I just would like to share one thought with you. As someone who appeared in Nutcracker since 1954, all over the world, and in the past 20 years has had to watch just as many, I think you'll all agree that this is the finest, most enjoyable production that we could possibly find right here on this stage. Thank you, Carol.
Good evening, and welcome to New Jersey Ballet's virtual celebration of the Nutcracker. Tonight's presentation will be the first in a five-part series marking the 50th anniversary of our production. Of course, the company is much older than that, but New Jersey Ballet achieved a new level of visibility when company founders Carolyn Clark and George Tomal first decided to produce the Nutcracker, a spectacular evening-length production in the grand manner. We can't perform the Nutcracker on stage this year, but the Nutcracker spirit is very much alive. It's inside all of us, in a secret place that the troubles of the world can never reach. Whenever you hear the music, the Nutcracker, you can think of it and start to dream. And in this series, we're going to show you the ballet in a way you've never seen it before. When New Jersey Ballet first performed the Nutcracker in 1971, the company's co-founder, Carolyn Clark, hired the guest artist to perform as the Sugar Plum Fairy's Cavalier. International ballet star Edward Villella partnered Jean Armin at the seminal performance at the Paper Mill Playhouse in Melbourne. But one of the most important things about a production with so many children in it is that eventually those kids grow up. Most of them go on to become audience members who enjoy remembering the fun they had performing in the Nutcracker and who want to share the experience with their own children. A few Nutcracker alumni, however, and there have been thousands of them over the years, go on to become professional dancers. So it wasn't long before New Jersey Ballet was able to field its own homegrown talent. We'll focus on them in a later segment. Right now, I'll just point out that at that very first performance in 1971, one of the little mice dodging a cannon shot in the battle scene was none other than Paul McRae, who is now the company's assistant director. Another Nutcracker alumnus is myself, and I'm now New Jersey Ballet's Director of Advancement. So you can see, the Nutcracker isn't just an ordinary ballet. It's a school for theater artists, and it has been an essential factor in New Jersey Ballet's growth over the years. New Jersey Ballet's version of the Nutcracker had two choreographers, Joseph Carow and George Tomal. Mr. Tomal was also a beloved teacher, but he did more than teach and choreograph. A seasoned veteran of stage and television, he made regular appearances in the Nutcracker, playing the role of the eccentric magician, Herr Drosselmeyer. Mr. Tomal played Drosselmeyer for almost 30 years, and his piquant interpretation of this character role was always a highlight of the party scene, which his students particularly looked forward to. Other distinguished Drosselmeyers at New Jersey Ballet have included Leonid Kozlov, Alexander Proya, and Umberto Teixeira. And I'd like to share with you a sampling of their work. Jersey Ballet has been dancing the Nutcracker for a very long time. It's been 50 years now, so you can bet there are some stories to tell. Staging the Nutcracker involves a lot of work, but it's fun work. Everyone is always glad to do it. because in the end, the Nutcracker makes so many people happy. And yes, we've made a lot of people happy over the last 50 years. Everyone at New Jersey Ballet is proud of the production, and we have every reason to be.
Hi, I'm Gabriel Van Oust, President and CEO of the New Jersey Symphony Orchestra. New Jersey is a state that's rich with terrific arts institutions. The New Jersey Symphony Orchestra has been proud to partner with New Jersey Ballet and Mayo Pack, two of our state's finest, for Nutcracker performances for the past 5 years. The orchestra's mission is to connect with the diverse communities of our state through the power of live symphonic music to inspire, entertain, and educate. Partnerships with organizations within the state are key to best reflecting and serving our communities. Collaborations such as these provide creative artistic experiences of the highest quality and enrich our audiences. We are stronger when we work together. This Nutcracker partnership has been incredibly rewarding for both our audiences and our performers. Tchaikovsky's incredible music conjures scenes of toys come to life, of the Nutcracker Prince and the Sugar Plum Fairy. The ballet is a Christmastime classic around the globe, and New Jersey Ballet's stellar production have brought this magical work to life for New Jersey families each December. Our musicians relish the opportunity to collaborate with the ballet and Mayo Pack to perform great music beyond the standard orchestral repertoire.
Hi, I'm Allison Lorena, President and CEO of Mayo Performing Arts Center. New Jersey Ballet has been a valued arts partner of MPAC for over 20 years, demonstrating extraordinary creativity and ingenuity in productions that set the standard for dance excellence in New Jersey. In 2010, for the first time in our history, MPAC partnered with the New Jersey Ballet to host an extended run of performances of their treasured production of The Nutcracker. It was wonderful to see that first year how MPAC patrons completely embraced the magic and beauty of the New Jersey Ballet's performances with great joy and enthusiasm. In the decades since, Clara, the Mouse King, the Sugar Plum Fairy, and other delightful Nutcracker characters have become the centerpiece of our holiday programming, drawing over 15,000 attendees annually. Many families come back year after year, making it part of their holiday tradition. The partnership of MPAC, New Jersey Ballet, and New Jersey Symphony Orchestra for Nutcracker truly demonstrates the collaborative spirit of New Jersey's nonprofit arts community. While it's unfortunate that we cannot stage Nutcracker this year due to the pandemic, we eagerly await next year's 50th anniversary celebration of this treasured New Jersey holiday tradition here at MPAC.
New Jersey Ballet's Nutcracker is a sizable undertaking. More than 300 people perform in it each year. Despite its heft, however, the production is flexible and able to tour. After a fire at the Paper Mill Playhouse destroyed the venue along with the Nutcracker sets and costumes, brand new ones too, New Jersey Ballet had no place to perform, so it began touring in-state. The fire occurred in 1980, and gradually the Nutcracker, with new scenery, began to make more and more stops at theaters ranging from Middle Township Performing Arts Center in Cape May to John Harms Performing Arts Center, now Bergen Pack, in Englewood. Once dancers experience life on the road, they may start to fidget, and it can be hard for them to sit at home. Since it first began touring, New Jersey Ballet has taken its beloved production, The Nutcracker, to other states too. They have visited New York, Pennsylvania, Ohio, Virginia, and South Carolina, bringing the joy of this holiday spectacle to audiences everywhere. One year, we took The Nutcracker all the way to Mumbai, India, where the people had never seen anything like it. Just imagine dancing The Nutcracker in Mumbai. Since 2010, however, The Nutcracker's main home has been the Mayo Performing Arts Center in Morristown. New Jersey Ballet gives the bulk of its performances there and is proud to collaborate with the New Jersey Symphony Orchestra. You'll hear more about the music in a future broadcast.
Every year, the New Jersey Ballet takes its production of The Nutcracker on the road, traveling from Cape May to Morristown. We met up with them at the Lavoie Theater in Millville to discuss what goes into perfecting a holiday tradition for over 40 years.
Every theater is different, has different spacing, has different technical issues, and those all have to be taken care of. And the dancers, I don't want the dancers worrying about those. I want to be sure when the curtain goes up that those are all taken care of in the rehearsal so that when they start performing, they're not worried about, you know, is there a problem in the wings?
Perfect.
I think everyone enjoys Nutcracker. It's become a holiday tradition in the United States, and we've been doing it for 43 years. We've given well over 800 performances for over a million people, and I've never missed a performance except when I had the flu.
Happy Nutcracker!
We're the Rubles, and I'm Christina.
I'm Nicolette.
And Rainer.
Me and my brother have been performing with New Jersey Ballet in their Nutcracker for 11 years.
11 years.
Yeah. At 9 years old, I was a clown, and then I went up to Flowers and Arabian.
I started as a little boy, and then I moved up to Arabian and Chinese, the guy with the ribbons, and famously known for Mother Ginger for shaking of the bosoms.
Yeah. What's your favorite memory?
Favorite memory would be playing Fritz of ever first time, having the nerves, knowing you start the show, the adrenaline, and my favorite part was the acting.
My favorite memory is playing Mouse King. I had to jump in on the spot, and with the adrenaline, I found it to be very, very fun to do. And, you know, mice is really one of the best roles, I feel.
Well, you guys were busy performing. I was doing some quick changes, which was kind of tight, some of those 90-second ones between the mice and the snow.
Or little boys or parents.
And then, the mice have like a unitard and it's very difficult.
Very difficult. Then with the hands and the fingers, that was always a rough one.
And then I later got involved in selling our Nutcracker souvenirs at the end. And then finally, with the help of my friends Dina and Karen, we designed the Nutcracker wear, which everybody loves and wears every year. And we'll miss this year not having that for the kids and the parents.
It's not a Christmas without Nutcracker.
That's for sure.
Snow. It is very odd not having a live Nutcracker since it takes part of our holidays by so much. The whole month of December is filled with it, so it's very odd. But
please subscribe to New Jersey Ballet so you can see more.
The German writer E.T.A. Hoffmann is the person who really invented the Nutcracker, which is based on his short story, The Nutcracker and the Mouse King. Later on, someone had a good idea to turn this story into a ballet. Here are a couple photos of the original production. This happened in Russia, where ballet was very popular. But Russia was still an empire then, with an emperor and an imperial court that was proud and supercilious. Some people there who thought they were important didn't believe that a ballet with so many children in it could ever amount to anything. They looked down their noses at a story where the heroine was just a child. Well, those people were wrong. Many years later, when the ballet came to America, it became a smashing success because there were so many parts for children, and because the heroine was a sweet and brave little girl. Once it came to America, the Nutcracker wasn't just a beautiful fantasy anymore. It became a project in which a whole community could get involved.
Thank you.
Children from the New Jersey School of Ballet have a number of opportunities to perform in the company's production as they advance as artists. First, they appear as clowns, turning, somersaults, and tumbling in front of Mother Ginger. Then the students rotate through a series of parts, going on to appear as toy soldiers, mice, angels, children in the party scene, and courtiers in the Land of Sweets. Even for the youngest cast members, appearing on stage is a big responsibility that they must take seriously. In future episodes, we will also tell you all about the lighting, the costumes, and the stage effects, how they make the Christmas tree grow, and how they make it snow on stage. We'll introduce you to some of the dancers who have played Clara over the years, and you will meet some of the charming young ladies who were chosen to share the part of Clara this year. We'll have a special segment on the Kingdom of the Sweets, offering insight into Tchaikovsky's music, with information about a newly discovered divertissement that New Jersey Ballet is adding to its time-honored production. And finally, we'll focus on the brilliant highlight of the second act, the sparkling dance of the Sugar Plum Fairy and Adagio, which guest artists Sarah Lane and Carlos Gonzalez will perform for us in a broadcast exclusive. There's a great deal of excitement to look forward to as we begin New Jersey Ballet's 50th anniversary Nutcracker season. Thanks so much for joining us tonight. We look forward to seeing you next week.